Hi everyone, we are from Group A. We're going to share several things about what we had learned in Kuka Robot Laboratory Part 3. First, the navigation of the Kuka Robot at expert level. Second, the function of sub-program. Third, the endless loop. And the last one is the external automation function.
For that video, we will teach the Kuka robot to take a cube from the cube magazine and then we put on the table. And from the table we take the cubes and then we transfer again to cube magazine and that's all for the task.
Hi, my name is Kevin Lu. So I will explain about the purpose of using sub program. It is to give the programmer check the error inside the program. If there is a long command program inside the file, it will need a lot of time for the programmer to check the error one by one. So by using sub program, we can let the programmer check the error inside the short command program. So it will reduce the time for the troubleshooting.
the command, the user group that we are using in the KCP. So to change the user group, first we go to configure and then user group. Then we log on into expert group using a password. The password here is KUKA, and then press log on. And then we'll be brought back to the programming inline programming screen, which we will have the expert group privilege. So with having the expert group privilege, we can now enter the loop command in the program. So first of all, we enter the loop command, and then we just put in the files to be read in the program. Let's say you have three files, and put in all the three files as shown. And then before we end the program, we have to put the end loop command to end the loop.
About external automation. So why we need external automation? As we all know that as an engineer, we just develop a program, but then we have to transfer to another company which the operator doesn't know how the program works or what we are going to do with the program. So we want to keep our program non-digital. So we, that's why we change our program to external automation. So I will say a bit about external automation. So in the external automation panel, you can see that we got a button for certain function. So if you want to change the Kuka control panel function into an external function, we have to first we have to change a certain number, a certain code, you can say, from Kuka code to external code. So you can see from the picture, for example, for Kuka code, the code is 1025, and then if you want to change it to the external automation, you have to change it to 7 or 8. So what I can say is that it is no longer valid due to the Kuka code. And you can see whether the program is run or not based on the color, the red light that will be displayed on the control panel. So it's all about
This is all about external
automation.
Thank you. Jasro from us. We from Group A. And I'm Fadli Ismail. Thank you for watching our video.